The journey so far. In the beginning, Death sought the Crowfather. But what he found was something more. A secret once forgotten. A path to another world.
Hey there, everybody. Kuddlesnot again. Here with episode 4. And we're going to go into the cauldron and get lots of tasty things.
Oh, just a pup.
Of course you don't know, you fat bastard. Anyway, he's not fat. He's just a giant. Whatever. So let's start the cauldron. So here in the cauldron is 5 Boatman Coins, 2 Book of the Dead pages, quite a few chests, as well as a pretty difficult boss, actually fairly challenging boss, especially Apocalyptic. And anything else in here? I guess the start of some pretty devious puzzles. Definitely not the as difficult as they get, but kind of like a hint of what's to come. But yeah. Alright, so first thing, so you want to grab the Shadow Bomb. If you remember from Darksiders 1, these are a little bit different. They were red, these are yellow. But that's not the only difference. Another difference is there's 2 kinds. There's the activated, there's the burning ones like this. And then there's the non-activated that need to be shot. These can be shot as well, but those you saw that just blew up and I opened up that chest over there. But what's different is that there's the same kind in Darksiders 1, but those blew up in your hand. The ticking started as soon as you grabbed it. With these, the ticking starts as soon as you throw it. That actually plays a big difference, not at the moment, but it does play a big difference in some later puzzles. So that's pretty important. Anyway, let's go grab those 2 chests. Whoa. And as I said in the last episode, I'm definitely going to be trying to avoid doing a lot of item management on screen. It actually isn't so bad in on the PC version, the one I'm on right now, because flipping to the inventory screen or to the skill up screen or the skill screen, it takes about a second. But on when I switch back to the Xbox, on the Xbox or PS3, it actually takes a good bit of time. Good bit of time in that you have to press it and then you have to wait, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 seconds. So, especially when I switch back to that version, and I'm, you know, and you do end up, you do go back and forth significantly as you progress and get more items. It's important that we don't waste a bunch of that time on screen. So before this episode, I put on my best items. I leveled up. I just added a skill to a skill point to to add health to my ghouls, not to the main ghoul, not to the power up the ghouls, but to heal them, and that's the next level. I think that's tier level 3. Anyway, and also it's just again a good practice, so we don't spend a bunch of time on inventory screen. We spend more time playing the game. All right, first Boatman coins right down here. Hello. You can also grab it on your way back. That's actually when most of you probably see it. And that's a fine time to grab it as well, but I just felt like grabbing it now. Because why not? Make sure to turn backwards and jump over there. Can't get over this way yet. Just kind of like teasing us over there. This is actually somewhat of a precarious jump, because especially if you're using Darksiders 1, you have a kind of a safety double jump. That, you have to be kind of careful when you jump. Alright, so now we see a bomb, we see a switch. So we gotta get to the bomb. So let's do some princin'. Or as a lovely viewer decided to mention, P.O.P. But I saw that, and the first thing I thought was popping. You know, and as a fan of community, I absolutely am down with popping. So, pop, pop. Alright. So be careful on this drop, because you can't fall into the lava. So just eyeball it and grab it. Kaplooey. Door unlocks jingle. Awesome. Okay, so now from there you can jump onto that little ramp. Destroy a crate or a barrel or whatever that is, because, you know, why not? And now we have big, epic battle scene. Uh-oh. These constructs are gonna hurt us. No, they're not. Guess we're gonna kill them. Something ghoulies. Get the hell out of the way. Dodge. Let's see if we can do this without getting hurt. That'd be amazing. Set a goal for ourselves. Okay. Ooh, that was a close one. Alright, come here, buddy. We don't have the moves yet. I'm so used to my combos being connected with, you know, higher level. Oh, almost got us trapped in there. No, I don't think so. Another thing to do with the ghouls is make sure, not make sure, but as you're summoning them, they can damage enemies, so make sure to use that to your advantage. So yeah, I guess I'll just make sure. Still, no damage, no direct damage from a hit anyway. I think I got, there's some damage from, like, a rumble or something? I don't know. Oh, I did get to, okay. Whatever. No direct, you know, physical attack damage. We'll take that as a victory. And oh, almost walked out of here without them boots! Yeah, we'll equip those. Okay. I don't think we have any special boots on. Oh, we do, but it's like four... It's like four arcane, four damage, or four defense, and... 3% guilt up. So I'd rather, at this point, I'd rather take the higher, significantly higher defense. Anyway, so treasure map, dungeon map, which now on your mini map and on the map screen, everything, whoa, is all the treasure chests are revealed as well as all the rooms, whether you explored them or not. However, stuff like the Book of the Dead or the Volgrim coins, the Boatman coins, are not visible, so be careful. Alright, so as you can see, that is a stalker. And it's exactly what we need to kill for our side quest to get the talisman. Which on the last episode we talked to Carney and told us we need to kill a stalker. See, there we go, stalker's bone. Don't need to pick up or anything. As soon as you kill a stalker, you can get it. But say that you didn't talk to Karn before you came in here, and you didn't know you needed the stalker's bone. So just killing the stalker doesn't give you the stalker's bone. You need to talk to Karn first. So if you killed all the stalkers in here and then talk to Karn, go, whoops, I need, and there's Bowman coin number 2 in here, or number 9 in total. So if you didn't talk to Karn first, and you kill that stalker, suddenly, and then you talk to him after the dungeon, suddenly it says, oh, you need to kill a stalker in the cauldron, but problem is there's no more stalkers in the cauldron. However, there is stalkers in the fjord and in other areas like the Weeping Crag, so you can go kill a stalker there, and that will progress the mini quest, the side quest for you. But however, now that we have the stalker bone, we can go talk to Karn. And he will tell us the location of the Mordant Dew. But we're not going to do that till after the cauldron's finished. Because we can't do anything with it right now, anyway. Alright, so, see, now we're dropping back over here. And this is where you can also grab the Volgrim coin. The first Volgrim coin in here. Volgrim coin. Let's say Volgrim coin. Boatman coin number 8. Anyway, Boatman coins. My guess. I'm not exactly sure what the name's supposed to mean, but if I had to guess. It'd have to be like, you know, because the boatman on the river Styx, death leads the dead on the river Styx and the underworld in Hades. That's what I would guess. But I am certainly not sure. So we used a shadow key to unlock that door, kill some pots. Because that's what death loves to do, is to kill environmental things like crates and pots. And this is our first, like, construct ball sphere puzzle. Although it's not much of a puzzle. It's definitely like, ooh, it's something to introduce the mechanic to you. And there's a puzzle with it later, but also it plays a major role in many puzzles in the future. So definitely get used to seeing those suckers. But before we pop our way over there, we'll go over here, get this wonderful chest, Same amount of damage with frost. Yep, we'll equip that. Cool. Ah, dang it. If you do it just right, you can pop your way up and then hit back here. But before, again, you go off, and after you grab the chest, or before, it doesn't matter. You want to go to the edge here of the handhold and jump over. Boom. And you could smash that environment if you want, but I don't need to. There's nothing in there. Well, I mean, there could be gold or potions, but I don't need to right now. Alright, so now we're back in this main room. And that's our objective. That's ultimately where we're going to end up, is that turning handle, which will restart the fire. Grab this random loot chest here. Nope, just going to sell him. So when we actually get a more diverse amount of items, I'll go and we'll look at the stats screen, and I will kind of explain the different stats a little bit more, as well as kind of explain my thoughts on them. And I will also, when we get a possessed weapon, I'll explain that and anything else. Okay, so we don't need to pick it up, so we grab that. And then anything else on those screens that I need to. But otherwise, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on them, like I said, because I just don't feel that it's necessary or worth your time, my time, or screen time, considering that all items are random, as well as everyone's playstyle is going to be kind of different. Okay, so again, you can drop down, but be careful. It is possible to, very possible, to fall into the lava if you just do it willy-nilly. Push this lever to kind of, like a ladder falling in Assassin's Creed, kind of let us get access to this area again pretty easily with not much hassle, because it also unlocks that door. Alright. Then there's a shadow key, but we're not going there yet. We're going here to go get the shadow key. And in here is also a wonderful Book of the Dead page. Ow! Kill these guys first. Where are you? Come here. Eat my scythe glaives. Boom. Alright. Let's go grab Book of the Dead page number 3. Then back here in this little corner. And now we have our first real puzzle of the game right here. Real puzzle, meaning that it's kind of like, takes a little bit of thought, and yeah, but they get much, much more devious, so be prepared. Alright, so as you can see, there's 3 different holes here. 1, 2 over there, and then 3. Those 2 are needed to be filled in order to bring down that gate. So obviously right now we only have 1 ball, so we don't want to put into one of those holes yet. So instead we're going to put into this hole. If you do end up putting it into one of those holes, that's not a big deal. Because there's something right here called the Shadow Bomb Dislodge. And if you remember over there, that Shadow Bomb used to destroy the corruption. You can use it to knock out the sphere out of the hole, which is what we'll need to do here anyway. But in case you put it into one of these 2 holes that don't help you get the sphere, the second sphere, you can also use the Shadow Bomb Dislodge to get it out of that hole and put it into the proper hole. I'm saying hole a hell of a lot. Hole, 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 hole. And then, like I said, you can use the Shadow Bomb Dislodge to get this sphere out of one of, or sorry, that sphere out of one of these 2 holes that we put in there first by accident. Anyway, so now we got both. And we're going over here. Sweet. Shadow key unlocked. Chest smashed. Man, there's no way those are reusable, are they? We're just, like, destroying them. Almost as badly as War does with his own fists. Where Death is a little bit more subtle. He just summons, like, Reaper, ghostly Reaper arms. And I think he somehow... This guy somehow got through the door. It's like he looks like he was about to run back. But hey. Whatever. Alright. to do. Whoop, we gotta kill these guys first. So, we'll get all the way through, and then we're actually gonna stop the episode right before we fight Garn. Oh, didn't want to do that yet. Actually, no, we can wait. No. Alright, so if you push this, as you can see, this sucker comes up. But it's only for a limited amount of time, so you gotta kind of do it quickly.
Time is of the essence.
As death tells you. But you don't want to yet, because there's a Vulgrim coin right there. Awesome. Vulgrim coin number 11. Jump. And there's some corruption. Will we get it? We'll see. Okay, so jump up. And make sure to do the lean backwards and then jump. Yes, just in time. From there, because otherwise, if you don't do that, you'll kind of run up the side of the cauldron and then you'll fall into the lava. So don't do that. Make sure to lean back. Alright. So like I said, we're going to stop right before Garn, unfortunately. Run up. But before we do that, we are going to grab the chest down here. The shadow bomb to destroy the crystals is right there. Boom. Explosion. And then from up here, we're going to jump. Epic landing. And grab the big chest here. Alright. Vagabond cover. I guess we'll take a special treat. We'll look at it. Oh, yes. Definitely. Okay. Equip. But since we're going with the... Oh, that was a different one. Okay, no, we're hold that one up.
Impossible.
Heal, use that, great. Impossible. Okay, so now that we got everything, we have to re-hit the switch. And I don't know what just happened there. See, that's one problem with popping, is that... So you have to be careful, so as you saw, like, even though my stick was pointed this way, the death was still like this, so I went up instead of to the right. So just be careful of death's current position, especially in Spricaria's handholds. Oh, ouch! Jerk. Jump. Glaive. Awesome. Okay. So, just to do it, we just have to hit the switch all over again. And you might think that after you defeat Garn, you can come back this way and then do it before you teleport out of here, but no. Because you actually want to go the other direction, because then that other direction is an additional Vulgrim coin, as well as another chest. So you want to grab it now before you fight Garn. Plus, having an extra chest is never a bad thing. Extra chest. No joke there. And we pop our way. Poppin', poppin', poppin'. In case I didn't quite explain it, poppin', P-O-P, Prince of Persia, becomes pop, so poppin', and then poppin', like, pop, pop, like, Community. So that show is amazing. Though without Dan Harmon at the helm, who knows if it'll be any good. So, little... helpful thing is telling us that you can fast travel from any dungeon to the vendors or to a city hub, and then you can come back exactly where you fast traveled out. You can have make a what's called a dungeon like marker. You can only have one dungeon marker at a time, so you can't have multiple dungeon markers across all of the dungeons. You can just have one at a time, so you can't really abuse it. So just carefully. I changed my mind. We're gonna totally fight Garn in this episode. Let's go do it! Oh, man. He's like, he was just waiting for someone to come in so he can make such a dramatic entrance. Okay. So the key with this bad boy is the side evade. That is the name of the game. Side evade. Side evasion. And that can be difficult because of the way that the camera works. But if you evade to the back, you're likely going to get skewered by that thing. Very, very likely. And then after you do a little bit of damage, he'll get stunned, so you can go and just wail on him. So, a good way to kind of distract him is by using ghouls. If you don't have the ghouls, that's fine. Just teleport dash your way through it. Ooh, that was a close one. Side evade. Okay, let's summon some ghoulies. He actually takes them out real damn quick if they get hit, so it's just like enough so that instead of him focusing on you for a second, he's focusing on. And they're doing a little bit of damage now, which is good. It's certainly not significant enough. Oh, get away from that explosion. Then reform. His reforms is like sort of a window. But the main one is... Ow! See, that happens. The main one is when you evade one of those drills. There you go. Like I said, if you side evade, you'll be good to go. Dark Avenger. This is a pretty awesome weapon. Level 5 weapon, so we can't use it quite yet. But, yeah. Okay, so that was Garn. And we did the whole cauldron in one episode. How awesome is that? So, we're going to heal. Grab the health potion, because it is not impossible. Although this one is. Oh no, because we'll heal. Alright, so it's usually a good idea to just clear out the environment for possible potions, as well as the guilt that they're obviously dropping. Guilt. It's guilty for some guilt. Guilt is my guilty pleasure. And we're gonna destroy some more pots! I am Death, destroyer of ancient pottery. That's why there's fragments. That's why there's only fragments of, like, Aztec and Mayan pottery. It's because a horseman of the apocalypse came through and just smashed it all looking for potions. Although this potion is impossible.
I cannot. Impossible. I cannot.
Come on.
Impossible.
Right there. Oh, I love that. That's amazing. Michael Wincott. Oh, man, I love that. I love that. Michael Wincott. What a star. That wrath potion, however, is not impossible. Although I did not see that they... Okay. Got some wraps. And there's one more thing before we grab. So you can fast travel out now, but you don't want to because there is... Actually, no, what am I talking about? Not yet. Not after you defeat Garn. After you turn the handle in here. That. That is when you want to possibly fast travel. But you don't want to because there's actually an additional Vulgrim Coin as well as a chest that you can grab first. Come on. Yes. We are making the fire flow. Or the lava. The lava flow. See, if that was all it took to activate the fire, it's like, okay, so a big bunch of enemies took over this, and in order to just piss off the makers for no particular reason, they just decided to turn this handle and stop the flow of lava, even though they probably would have been left alone if they didn't, you know, turn the lever. And within one of these boxes was our fourth Book of the Dead page. Yummy. 6 more for the first chapter. And another chest in here. Clearly marked on your map. 16 shroud. Eh, I'm not gonna look at it yet. Alright, so now we get to go down some circular stairs, but you're not going to go down the stairs, you're Death, you're going to jump. And you're going to get a Vulgrim Coin on the way down. Boom, number 12. And then before you go, you want to grab this. Cool.
I cannot. Impossible.
It's impossible. Impossible! And again, before you fast travel out, it's easiest to just go out here at the exit and talk to Karn now to forward this, the Maker's side quest. The Maker's talisman Shaman's Craft. That's the name of it. Side quest. Let's just talk to him right now.
The mountain has a voice! How did you... No, no. Doesn't matter. You have done what we... what I failed to do. You must take the good news to Alya as soon as you can.
What is Mordant Dew?
Mordant Dew is the venom those stingers get you with if you let them too close. You'll find them in Drenchfort. Walk softly, though. Those stings are nasty.
Certainly are, although we will be acquiring a weapon that makes it a little bit easier. All right, guys, thanks for watching. This has been Kuddlesnot. Signing off. If you'd like the spreadsheet guide, please send me a PM if you're a subscriber. If not, if you're not a subscriber, subscribe! It helps me out a lot. I really appreciate it. All right. Thanks, guys, again. This has been Cuddlesnot, signing off, and I will see you again next time.
I don't know. I'm just a pup.